After 2.5 months of ownership and 5,000 miles driven in our new 2021 Toyota Sienna, I want to share with you my top 5 likes and dislikes about this vehicle. We have a premium trim of this minivan, and it came equipped with all-wheel drive rear entertainment system and 1500 watts 110-volt electric inverter options. Hello and welcome to Telvia. The new hybrid powertrain on new 2021 Sienna minivan was the primary selling feature for us, and it is the number one on my likes list. After 5,000 miles consisting of 90% high-speed highway driving and 10% city miles, we currently have 36.5 mile per gallon average fuel economy. This is actually 1.5 mile per gallon higher than the 35 mile per gallon fuel economy published by Toyota for all-wheel drive equipped vehicles. We're more than delighted by our van's fuel efficiency. Many question whether the hybrid power plant in new Sienna has sufficient power in stop-and-go traffic or when merging on the highway ramps. Based on my experience driving the new Sienna, I feel that the van has sufficient power off the line and even in high-speed passing on an uphill highway. In my opinion, this vehicle's driving dynamics are more limited by the suspension tune rather than power delivery in most situations. In this hybrid powertrain, Sienna uses their new power split device, which combines power of the gas engine and two electric motors. It serves the function of continuously variable transmission. But in contrast to other continuously variable transmissions on the market, it has no lag in power delivery and it sounds assertive and confident rather than whining when rapidly accelerating. In fact, this engine sounds similar to other four-cylinder engines. I used to own Mazda CX-9 with a 2.5-liter four-cylinder turbo engine and, to my ears, the 2.5-liter hybrid Toyota engine is quieter and more pleasant-sounding than in Mazda. In summary, we are delighted by a new hybrid powertrain in the Sienna. While there are different numbers quoted on various websites about the total cargo capacity of 2021 Sienna minivan, the fact remains that the 2021 Sienna is one of the most capacious and ergonomic vehicles for hauling people and cargo inside. A potential option of reconfiguring this van for comfortable sleeping and camping for two people was the number two selling feature for us, and this van's capacity is number two on my likes list today. If you have not seen my camping sleeping conversion video, you can find the link to it in the description. Because we're using our van mostly for long distance travel, the cabin quietness and comfort are critically important to us. During the initial test drive, I was impressed with how quiet the cabin was, even when rapid accelerating and revving up engine. After driving our Sienna on long trips, the initial impression is confirmed, and it exceeds our expectation in comparison to vehicles we previously owned and test driven. At a 70 mile per hour on a typical highway surface, we consistently see 60 to 65 decibels of noise level inside the cabin. In my previous video about using air conditioning system for camping and sleeping in our Sienna, I have shown that the cabin noise inside the van when parked and when the engine and AC are on was around 45 decibels. So the additional 20 to 25 decibels come from the high revving engine, tire, and wind noise. Even on a rough pavement at a 70 mile per hour, we see only 70 to 72 decibels of noise. These are very impressive numbers. Many luxury vehicles have published cabin noise of 70 to 72 decibels. Toyota has done a marvelous job making cabin of this van quiet at any speed and on any driving surface. Bravo, Toyota! And this quiet interior is my like number three. The 2021 Toyota Sienna is not a small vehicle. It measures 120.5 inches in the wheelbase and 204 inches in overall length. I was concerned that driving dynamics of such long vehicle, especially with a soft suspension, will feel as uncontrolled and will be front-wheel biased. Driving it, I found that all-wheel drive feature in new Sienna is a marvel of engineering. It engages rear wheels to assist accelerating out of the corners when powering uphill, and it charges hybrid battery while braking and during downhill descents. The energy monitor on the center display is fun and entertaining to watch. It is interesting how frequently the power controller switches from engine to electric power and back to engine while charging and using battery to optimize power delivery and fuel efficiency. In my experience with this all-wheel drive hybrid Sienna, I felt a number of times rear wheel corrections in corners similar to what I have experienced in vehicles equipped with so-called torque vectoring technology. Torque vectoring works by applying brakes or power to one of the rear wheels during aggressive braking or acceleration while turning to compensate for oversteer or understeer in these situations. I was not able to find any info whether Toyota indeed employs torque vectoring in new Sienna. However, since it uses a separate electric motor to power rear wheels, this might be possible. In our limited off-road driving, in the rain on a hilly gravel road, our Sienna handled very well, and it felt secure and sure-footed in a number of tight off-camber turns. Another reason the new Sienna handles so well, especially in city driving situations, is its 39-foot turning circle diameter. For such a long vehicle, it is incredibly maneuverable. In my previous midsize SUV, I used to make a 3-point turn in order to exit from my driveway. In the new Sienna, it is just 1-point turnaround. The new 2021 Toyota Sienna exceeds my expectations on the driving dynamics front. The all-wheel drive and the tight turning circle of this van earn it my like number 4. We never owned or rented an RV or had any experience with camper vans before we decided to buy new Sienna this year. Reading and watching YouTube videos about what's important when camping for more than one night, we quickly realized that a portable car refrigerator is a great add-on to any camping vehicle. Many owners of previous model Sienna vans have installed aftermarket 110-volt power inverters to use a refrigerator in the van. In 2021, Toyota introduced a 1500-watt 110-volt power inverter option for Sienna minivan. We decided that this new inverter is a must-have option when shopping for our van. The dimensions of new refrigerator were critical for the design and build of my camping-sleeping conversion. Shortly after delivery of our van, I ordered a highly popular 43-quart portable refrigerator by IceCore. See a link in the description. After 5 camping trips, when we brought with us foods requiring a refrigerator, our enjoyment and comfort traveling and camping increased dramatically. We're now planning new, longer, and more daring adventures, so the new 110-volt power inverter feature is my strong like number 5. Okay, for those who are waiting for my dislikes, let's discuss them now. None of these dislikes are showstoppers for buying a new Sienna, but these dislikes hamper our excitement about otherwise terrific minivan, and talking about them may be useful to new Sienna shoppers. The number one dislike, particularly relevant for a minivan, is about cup holders. There are 8 cup holders in the front cabin and 9 cup holders in the back of the van. In total, 17 cup holders. The travesty with these cup holders is that only one of them is large enough to accommodate a standard thermos-style water bottle. My wife and I are constantly competing for this one cup holder. Last week, we finally bought smaller and skinnier water bottles to use in our van. Some cup holders don't have sufficient room height-wise, even for standard but taller water bottles. Perhaps the bottles and cups are smaller in the rest of the world, but this minivan is built in the US for the US customers. My dislike number 2 is the rear entertainment system option. In order to get the all-wheel drive and electric power inverter options, we had to buy platinum trim, which unfortunately comes with the rear entertainment system option included. My attempts to set up wireless mirror cast of the content from my iPad to the built-in foldable screen of this system were futile. After connecting iPad via HDMI, I realized that the image shown on the built-in display is not full screen and too small for watching anything from rear seats. It's easier and more convenient just to use iPad directly. They included over-the-ear wireless headphones, are heavy and uncomfortable. The foldable rear entertainment screen is stored in a bulbous bulge that takes headroom space in the center of the cabin. I doubt that even families with small children would find this system usable. My next dislike, number 3, would apply to many new vehicles, and it concerns the built-in car navigation versus navigation using Apple CarPlay functionality. Car manufacturers should resign to the fact that nowadays most drivers have smartphones and that Google and Apple Maps navigation apps are so much better than their built-in Navi offerings. I tested the built-in Navi app in New Sienna and found it to be okay, but lagging in giving timely directions when driving on the city streets. I missed a couple of turns as a result. I drove the same route with Apple Maps via Apple CarPlay, and it kept me prepared for upcoming turns in timely, relaxed manner. While I praised the cabin interior and quietness early in this video, the front seats in New Sienna are not comfortable, primarily because the front seats don't have sufficient tilt control. The driver's seat has this adjustment, but it doesn't have enough range to achieve comfort. The passenger seat doesn't even have a tilt adjustment option at all. And this is in a top-of-the-line trim of New Sienna. Both my wife and I are average height at 5'8" and 5'11" respectively. And both of us find that we need more tilt adjustment in the seats to make them comfortable. The lack of proper front seat tilt adjustability is my dislike number 4. To mitigate this problem, I installed longer seat mounting bolts that allowed me to put a 1-inch spacer to raise the front of the seats. This modification with the built-in tilt adjustment made the driver's seat sufficiently comfortable, but the passenger seat comfort is still lacking. I want to caution my viewers, however, that proper mounting of seats to vehicle frame is critically important for safety of occupants. I modified seats mounting in my van at my own risk. I do not recommend this modification to anyone. Please advise your automotive professional regarding your vehicle modification needs. This brings me to my last and final dislike number 5. And this is a very common complaint about non-removable second-row seats in the new 2021 Sienna. Many owners of previous generation Sienna have bought and loved their vehicles because the second-row seats are removable. Toyota states that the second-row seats in 2021 Sienna are not user-removable. This is likely because in 2021 model, the second-row seats have airbags built in the seats. Disconnecting airbags requires precautions and technical expertise to avoid accidental discharge of the airbags, and it may cause other electronic malfunctions in the vehicle. I was able to remove and reinstall second row seats in our 2021 Sienna several times depending on our travel needs, and found a way to bypass the airbag warning on the display. I did this at my own risk, however. Because of manufacturer's statement that the seats are not removable, and for safety and potential liability reasons, I will not provide instructions about my seat removal and airbag warning bypass in this video. I hope Toyota will issue their official instructions for the second row seat removal soon. Until then, some buyers may look at a competing Chrysler Pacifica minivan, which offers automatically folding second row seats. If you enjoyed this video and found it helpful, please like, comment, and subscribe. Your feedback and comments are helpful for making new videos that you enjoy watching. Cheers, and hope to see you around next time.